Welcome to St. Joseph School Online Teaching. This educational video is prepared for the students of Class 4 and the subject is English. Let us learn about the prose lesson number 3, and the name of the lesson is On a Beam of Light. The author is Jennifer Byrne. The best way to learn a lesson is to understand the structure. English is structured with grammar. In this particular lesson, we will try to learn a very important concept of grammar, that is the pronouns and its functions. Let us understand the formation of this sentence. Sumit stayed at home and Sumit studied storybooks. What changes can be suggested to improve the presentation of the sentence? In the sentence, the noun Sumit is appearing twice. It can be replaced with the word he. So, we can rewrite the sentence saying that Sumit stayed at home and he studied storybooks. This improves the presentation of the sentence. Now, let me explain with few more examples. Ramya helped in cooking and also Ramya completed the homework. If you carefully observe the sentence, the word Ramya is being repeated. We can rewrite the sentence replacing the second Ramya with the word she. Ramya helped in cooking and she completed the homework. So here the word Ramya is being replaced by the word she. Let me explain with one more example. In the study room, Ramu is sitting and Ramu is learning grammar. Here, again, the word Ramu is being repeated. So, we can rewrite the sentence replacing the second Ramu with the word he. In the study room, Ramu is sitting and he is learning grammar. The words he and she are examples of pronouns. What is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word that replaces a noun in a sentence. In other words, the words used in place of nouns are called as pronouns. Now, why do we need a pronoun? The purpose of pronouns is to avoid repetition and make sentences smoother and easier to understand. Now, let us learn about the functions of pronouns, which is the structure of our lesson. A pronoun acts as the subject of a verb. Sumit stayed at home. Sumit is the subject. Stayed is the verb and home is the object. In place of Sumit, we can rewrite the sentence using he. He is reading a book. Here, he is the subject pronoun. A pronoun also acts as the object of a verb. Let me explain. Sumit stayed at home. He is reading a book. He is learning the new words from it. He is subject pronoun. Book is the object. It is object pronoun. Let me explain with one more example. Ramya helped in cooking. She completed the homework. She did it nicely. In this sentence, we can identify the subject pronoun and the object pronoun. She is the subject pronoun. It is the object pronoun. Now, we will learn about the different types of pronouns. Pronouns can be divided into three groups: personal pronouns, possessive pronouns, demonstrative pronouns. In the personal pronouns, I, he, she, it, we, you, they. Coming to the possessive pronouns, hers, his, mine, ours, yours, this. Demonstrative pronouns: this, that, these, those, them. Children, I hope you have understood what are pronouns and its functions. Now, let us do a small exercise of identifying the pronouns in the following sentences. I cleaned the floor. He is good at drawing. The dog is hers. The shirt is mine. In these sentences, I is the pronoun. He, hers, mine. The car is theirs. Those birds are flying south. Their clothes are wet. This is my house. In these sentences, theirs, those, their, this are the pronouns. Now, let us learn about the vocabulary. What is vocabulary? New words in English are known as vocabulary. These vocabulary words have been picked up from the lesson. Let us read one by one. Curious, worried, amazed, graduated, theories, invisible, genius, exciting, wondering, discovered. Let me repeat again. Curious, worried, amazed, graduated, theories, invisible, genius, exciting, wondering, discovered. Now we move on to the meaning of these words. Curious, eager to know or learn something. The meaning of curious is eager to know or learn something. Worried, anxious. Worried, anxious. Amazed, surprised greatly. Amazed, surprised greatly. Graduated, passed exams. Graduated, passed exams. Theories, explanations. Theories, explanations. Here the father is trying to explain the daughter about the precautions to be taken about the corona. Invisible, that cannot be seen. Invisible, that cannot be seen. Genius, great and unusual ability. Genius, great and unusual ability. We are talking about a boy who performed his first surgery at the age of 7. Exciting, feeling of happiness and enthusiastic. Exciting, feeling of happiness and enthusiastic. Wondering, admiring. Wondering, admiring. Discovered, to find something that nobody had found before. Discovered, to find something that nobody had found before. Here the scientists have found out a new virus called coronavirus. It's also called as COVID-19. Our lesson on a beam of light is about a great scientist whom you can see on the screen. His name is Albert Einstein. Now let us learn more about this great scientist. He was a German-born scientist. That means he was born in Germany. He was hardly able to speak till he was 3 years old, which is very unusual. One day when he was ill, his father presented him a compass which drew his attention, because in whichever way he turned the compass, the needle always pointed towards the north. When he was a student, He was a question bank in the class, which means he asked too many questions to the teachers. A beam of sunlight drew his attention one day when he was riding his bicycle. He dreamt to ride on the beam of sunlight instead of on the road. His ideas were praised by the science magazines. People called him a genius. Music motivated him a lot. Whenever he had any tricky problem, he used to take up his violin and play. And music gave him better ideas and relaxation to him. His scientific theory gave a new understanding to magnetism. He contributed a lot to the advancement of science. So children, after going through the story, what we could understand is that to become a great scientist like Einstein, one needs these three virtues. What are they? They are wondering, thinking, imagining. I repeat again, wondering, thinking, imagining. If you start inculcating these virtues in you, you can understand things better. By asking questions and getting answers for these questions, you can move towards a new world. Who knows, one day you can become one more Einstein.